One.
Hello, 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 hello. Good afternoon. How are you doing? Maybe good evening, good morning, wherever you are. Thank you so much for joining me here on the Hangout. It's Facebook Live. And my name is Crystal Kwame Ayi, also known as Your Ultimate Turn Up MC. I know people will be asking me, what is all this, Your Ultimate Turn Up MC? But fundamentally an MC and now TV host as well as radio show host as well. So I host the... what's it called again? The Block Party, pardon me, on 3FM 92.7. That's on Fridays from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. Every Friday, I'm on there with DJ NK. And we just bring the party to you wherever you find yourself. As long as your radio set is tuned to 3FM 92.7, we're bringing you the party. I'm also co-host of the Ladies Circle on TV3, which shows at 6 p.m. on Saturdays from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. We're there. And now there's a new show as well. It's called Battle of the Sexes. And that also comes to you this Saturday. The first of its kind, actually, this Saturday at 5:30 p.m. on TV3. Now, this is a session that allows you to get to know me a bit more, so we'll get into that. Keep sending your questions because I'm here to answer all of them. Let's just get interactive. Let's have fun with this. I think it's a whole 360. You get to know me a bit more. So as we go along, you can keep sending your questions, but I'm going to start by talking a bit more. As I mentioned earlier, my name is Crystal, and C stands for curious, H is for hilarious, R is for reasonable, Y is for you guess, S is for sweet, T is for perhaps talkative, A is for maybe all-knowing, I don't know, and L, how can I be all-knowing, really, how can I? Lord, I'm sorry. And L is for likable, I guess. So you get to, choose as well which one of the attributes makes you happy. That's it. Now I'm going to go through a few of the questions that are coming in. I was born in Accra and I have lived here all of my life, really. Does your name... okay, I've done that. If you have to change... no, if I had to change my first name... I don't think I ever would, because my name actually means carrying Christ, and it's something that I strongly believe in. You know, it's such a huge task. Crystal, carrying Christ. So you can't have that name and play. You know, it means that I have to carry Christ everywhere I go. And I think it's a nice purpose in this life. I grew up in Kolebu, in Accra, Ghana. Yeah, I used to get a lot of questions. I used to get a lot of questions about Kolebu. Anytime I told people where I live, you live at Kolebu, and then the next question is, isn't it a hospital? How do you live in a hospital? How could I live in a hospital? Where do the doctors live? Where do the nurses live? And all the others who work in the hospitals. There are accommodation places for them as well. So from doctors to nurses to all of them, maintenance staff, all of them, they all live in Kolebu. So I grew up there as well. I had my basic education in Bishop Auwe's school. Yeah, Bibosa. In Bishop Auwe's school, the yellow and the blue, colors too. It is you we defend. Always to the end. I know you can finish it if you went to Bishop Auwe's. So that's it. I went to Bishop Auwe's as well. And then I went to Achimota School, so I'm at Akora. Yeah. So people don't like the black and the whites, but yeah, that's where we're from. Whether you like it or not, that's us. And still going through the questions. What else can I say about myself? Let me know. What do you want to know? I love chocolate. I didn't want to say it, but I had to say at this point. I love chocolate, and it got really close to an addiction, so I had to get off of it, because in this life you cannot be an addict to anything, right? Right? Yeah, it's not right. As long as the thing is ruling, as long as the thing is controlling you, nope, you have to find a way to break away from it, because you have to have control all the same. I also love fitness. I'm a fitness freak. I'm a fitness freak. Yeah, I skip rope. I like to call myself a jump rope champion because, yeah, I think I earned it. I do an average of 2,000 to 2,500 a day within 30 minutes. I give myself 30 minutes and then I jump rope. So it's also high intensity. And for those who know what high intensity interval training is, it means that you have to give yourself some rest days so that your body can actually go through the process of healing and of burning the calories as well. Actually burning fat as well. And so it's every other day I do my skipping. And if I'm not skipping, I'm trying to eat well as well. I don't know why it's taking me forever to lose as much as I want to, but we're still trying. And as long as we're staying healthy and staying fit as well, we're good to go. Yeah, okay. So this one just came in. Can you walk us through your career? What did you start from and what did you end? Oh, wow. This is a good one. I have actually done a whole lot within a short period of time. I did my service in procurement in one of the hospitals in Accra. I did that, and after my service, I worked on my business for a bit. At the time, I was doing fashion pieces with African print, and so I had, I made bow ties, I made hair accessories as well. Big, extravagant pieces. They're statement pieces. So as long as someone walked into the room, you'd see that. And then from that, I went into acting for a bit with Uncle Ebo, but I'm still with the group all the same. And then I got another job in advertising, which I did for a period of time. I did production, I did accounts management, I also did script writing, copywriting. So I did that as well. And from that point into banking, which I stayed for 2 years ish. I did banking for 2 years, and now I'm here. In between, I did my emceeing as well. Next one. I loved you on Ghana's Most Beautiful. Are we seeing you on there soon? I think so. Are we seeing me on there soon? Are we seeing me on there soon? Yes, I hope so. Thank you so much for loving the experience as well. I enjoyed it also. It was great. It was amazing. A bit different from what I know. And that's what made it even more interesting. That's what made it even more fun. Every week I came on with new energy just to enjoy the full experience. What does that mean? I'm sure if you type in hullabaloo on Google, you see a lot more interesting definitions for that. How come you're so energetic? Is Giovanni your twin? I think Giovanni is actually my big brother, not by blood, but by energy and by number nineism. And so Giovanni is my big brother. He's not my twin. And energy, really, it's just who I am. It's just how I live. It's just all I've known. So anytime people just come and say, "Hey, you're so lively, you're so energetic," it's what I know. So it's a bit confusing, and it makes me ask, what other way could I really be? I've tried to be calm before, and that's just, really just being laid back and everything, but I don't know how to do it because it's just not me. So it's natural, and we bless God for it. I'm guessing if you want some of that as well, because some people have asked, you can ask God, Lord, make me energetic, make me lively. Amen. Amen. What's your inspiration? Ooh, that's sweet. My inspiration, I have so many of those. Again, depending on what project I'm on. God, purpose, the purpose that He's, blessed me with. My inspiration. I love human beings as well, and so their well-being is also one of the things that inspires me. I like to see people when people are happy, when people are joyful. It makes me happy as well. And so when things are not going well for them, that's what their problems speak to me. And if I can do something to help them in any way, to at least enjoy, the goodness of life, at least to remember who God is in their life, at least to remember all the blessings that they've had before these tough times. I mean, if I can be there for them, why not? If I can do that, why not? So humanity is a huge, humanity and the well-being of humanity is one of my inspirations as well. Abrantia Kofi, I'm live here. Yeah, Abrantia Kofi, what's good? What's good? What's good? Thank you for joining in. Are you into a are you in a serious relationship or are you married? Can I sing a song for you? I want to dedicate this song to my mother. Just jokes, just jokes. I'm not married though. I'm not married. And if you want an answer to the next one, you might have to, hit me up on Instagram. I'm just saying, I just don't feel like, yeah, right? Okay. You already know the answer, so yeah. Please, what has been your biggest disappointment and how did you deal with it? Wow, this is deep. Deep. Biggest disappointment. Biggest disappointment. Biggest disappointment. I can't pick one. I like to go through life, pick the lessons, and move on. And so I forget selectively negative things that happened to me. I forget selectively things that just didn't make me happy, but I pick the lessons and move on all the same. There have been so many things that have really just disappointed me, like, putting in all your energy into a project and the project just didn't turn out the way you wanted it to be, you know, because not exactly because I didn't put in as much effort as I needed to, but because of the external forces that were beyond my control. You know, trying to secure a job with a client and, you know, going through all the meetings, putting in all the ideas. I'm a creative, and so I'm bringing ideas together, I'm creating content, I'm putting things together, and then the client just says they're going on with another person who's probably cheaper, they're going on with another company that's probably, you know, fits within their budget or something. That is a huge disappointment, and it certainly can scar you. So might as well just pick up the lessons from that point and move on. How did I deal with it? Well, I like to believe that what's mine is mine. So I just keep on being my best self at that point in time. I say at that point in time because you keep growing, you keep learning. So at that point in time, I just be my best self, you know, empower myself, encourage myself to be better and move on, right? Yeah, because other jobs will come. So if you're not being your best self, how would you be adequate enough to execute that job? How would you be, right? You have to be your best self. Okay, next one. Shout outs to Nancy though, tell her I love her. Nancy, that's actually from me. Please, what has been, okay, I've read that already. How do you manage being an MC and being a TV presenter? It's pretty easy, really. It's more, or less, it's not the same thing, it's just different. It's kind of like the same thing, but different platforms, really, and different audiences. With MCing, your audience is right in front of you. With MCing, all the feedback, everything is live. You are receiving it, you have to understand your audience, you have to understand where they are, and, you know, provide, meet their needs there and then, and you have to make the show go on there and then. Same thing with TV presenting. I believe the show has to go on. If you make a mistake, you pick up, you move on. But the difference is that some shows do not have a live audience, and so you're talking straight to the camera. It may look awkward from, you know, wherever you find yourself. It may look a bit awkward, but I think that's the main difference, the fact that, you know, that the audiences are different. Also with MTV, sometimes you have a live audience, and so it just brings that back to you. You get the live, you know, experience, you get the live vim and vigor, all the energy going through you, and you're actually speaking to people directly and getting direct feedback, so it's great. I love both of them equally, and I wouldn't change that for the world. Where are you from? Hometown and tribe and region. Okay, so I'm from Ghana. Uh-huh. I'm full Ghanaian. I'm from Teshi, so I'm Ghana, yeah, and part Voltairean. I'm part Airway, so I'm from the Volta region as well. It's not even the Volta region anymore, it's Oti region now. So 5 years ago, I would have said I'm from the Volta region, but now I'm from Oti region as well, so half and half. Pops is from Teshi, and my mom's is from Oti region, so that makes me Airway and Ghana, but I'm a global citizen, so I go as far as Antarctica and the Arctic. Crystal, you sing very well from sources. Can you sing for me? That's Nana Kwesi Inachota. Ah, Nana Kwesi, why wouldn't I sing for you? I mean, I'm here for you, aren't I? Let me sing a song. Sing a song of sixpence, the pockets full of rye. 4 and 20 blackbirds baked in a pie. I can't sing the rest of the song, so let me see what other song I'll sing. When the pie was open, the best pants are singing. Oh, wasn't that a dainty dish to serve before the king? Let me think of a song. A quick one. Right now, it's a song that's in my head. Let me see. I'll think of a song and I'll sing that for you. There's an EL song that I love so much. Yeah, if it's not EL, who is it, right? Okay. Random. Augustine, help me with the song title. I know it's very random. That's just who I am. R for random.
See, if you don't know how I do my thing, you be my God.
Oh, I don't know all of it. If you don't wonder how I do my thing, you be my God. No money, how me here while I can't give you my God. Oh, I don't know where it is. Me my God. Hey, like a sickly one, me coco in my God. Oh, hey, I never the hunger, never worry. Oh, my body, my body. No, you be my God. Oh, hey, wait, I go to shocky for my God. Oh. Azonto for my God, I go shokoto for my God, and nene, eh, and nene, eh, I go shoki for my God, Ava, Azonto for my God, shokoto for my God, and nene, oh. I can go higher, but if I think of another one, I'll sing for you. Okay. I hope you love that, Nana Kwesi in Action Water. That was specially for you. Who is your favorite artist and what's your favorite song? It's kind of like I answered it already, funny enough. I have, I don't have one favorite. I have many favorites. I have songs that speak to various moods, various vibes at various points in time. EL is one of my favorite artists. I've loved his music from, I think, his first song. And that was Waiting Day Happen, baby mama, like, Waiting Day Happen. That was long ago. And when I heard it, I was like, this voice, like, what is it about it? And that song was different from all the other songs that were played at the time. And then I realized he went on with, tell your mama and your papa, say, I like you, girl. Then Azonto, you know, Kalu, Kalu. I mean, hey, did I forget Obumo? That was that one that shook Accra, Ghana, and the whole world, really. And then from that point on, I think he's an amazing lyricist as well. So I can't pick a song from EM, not just one. There's so many of them. On a Long Tin was a great one as well, Kalu, On a Long Tin. The whole Something Else album is my favorite. It had two songs, A and B, two sides, you know. I think about 24 songs-ish. The whole Something Else album was good for me. I love Whitney Houston, amazing. Tasha Cobbs, amazing. I love so many artists. Manifest is another amazing one that I think needs you know, props for his style, for his genius, you know, lyrics. Wow, the word is not coming anymore. For his genius in putting down lyricism. His genius lyricism. Thank you so much, Augustine. Yeah, for his genius lyricism. And Burna Boy is amazing as well. I love Burna Boy. So since we talk about Burna Boy, The Roots, taking it far back to Fela Kuti. I love Fela Kuti. The genres are so many. So many. I love Red Hot Chili Peppers. And that's in like the rock zone. I love Coldplay. The genres are many. If I go through my playlist right now, I'll keep going and going and going and going and going. But yeah, so many of those. My favorite song? I don't know what my favorite song is. But from any one of these and many more. Crystal Dear, no mistake. Hey, she's never guilty. She's never guilty of anything negative on Lady Circle. When will you be guilty? But I was guilty last week. And I think really guilty, not guilty, is just about, I think it's just about luck, really. You know, there are times when all the questions favor you, and there are times when they just don't. And so that's why I'm not guilty. It's not like I'm trying to form or anything like that, but you can't always be guilty, right? You can't always be guilty. So yeah, it's that shuffle, really. Let's keep praying that the next set of episodes, you'd actually see me guilty, all right? Awesome. I want to follow you. What's your social media? Why not? What's your social media handles? So I'm at Crystal K-I-E on all platforms. Crystal K-I-E, that's CHRYSTALKARYEE on Instagram. I'm most active on Instagram, on Twitter as well. And on Facebook, if you type in the same Crystal K-I-E, I'm that on there as well. Oh, and I'm also on TikTok, so you can join me on TikTok. I signed up a few months ago, took it off, but I decided just yesterday that I should come back on there and have a bit more fun. So you can join me on there and let's have fun on TikTok. Next up, how do you describe yourself in 5 words? Hilarious. Or comic, hilarious. Brilliant. Edgy, fantastic, God's baby, yeah. That's it, so 5 words. Why do you always, this is from Purple. Purple, I don't know this one is from you. Why do you always shout, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, now drop, hey, breathe in, breathe out, come on, breathe in, breathe out. Well, I just shall breathe in, breathe out, because really you need a breather in life at some point in time, all through your day. You know, if you're working, you have to take a break at some point, and guess what? breathe in, breathe out. And it really just helps you to relax. And that's when you're actually able to do a lot more work, a lot more fruitfully, a lot more productively, work more productively throughout your day. So why don't you just take a break? You know, and to also transition from work time to play time, you have to breathe in, breathe out, and drop, 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 drop. Someone is dancing here. Shout out, shout out, shout out. I can't understand your energy. I can't understand it either, really. And I guess it's just a gift from God. What makes you special? My first time listening to you, and I think I like you. Oh, thank you so much. What makes me special? I'm guessing that that's what it is. And the fact that God's really got me all through, you know, God's got me. I just try as much as possible to connect to Him, and everything else is what you see. One of my things in life really is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. And it's just something that I hold on to all the time through anything and everything. What is your favorite or preferred type of outfit or clothing? I'm edgy. I'd like to describe my style as Afro-funky. So once it is African, it has the African elements in there, African symbols, like what I'm wearing exactly. Once it has the African symbols, and this is clearly African, you know what I mean? When you say an African thing, African piece, these are the things that come with it, the patterns and all of that, even the kind of fabric that it is. I like African pieces a lot, and I like to mix and match. I like to wear pieces that people don't regularly wear. I like to wear pieces that on the regular people would be scared to wear. Just look at them and no, not me, how would I do that? I did. I'm like, yes, that is what I want to wear. I'll try it. And then as I see that piece, I'm running it through all the other pieces that I have in my wardrobe to see what I can match it with. So there are the basics, which are your, you know, regular pants, your denim pants, your shorts, everything else. But I have to throw that African piece or African element in there some way, somehow. Preppy, edgy, Afro-funky. Yeah, that's it. With a bit of classic sometimes, okay? Oh, okay. It's Nicholas. Hi, Nicholas. What's good with you? What's the one thing that you've been told that keeps you going? At a point, maybe, you wanted to give up or something. That's actually great. I like this question a lot. What's that one thing that you've been told that keeps you going? Everyone loves it when they receive positive feedback. Everyone loves it when they receive good words from people. It just encourages them. It just encourages me. And I think that being told that I'm great and I'm different. And so the fact that I'm different doesn't mean that I should just listen to whatever is happening. The fact that I'm different doesn't mean I need to conform. That's really what I want to say. The fact that I'm different doesn't mean that I need to conform. And so I think that really hits me. And I'm saying this because I go through, it's getting deep right now. It's getting deep. It's getting deep right now. I say I'm different because, like, as you keep mentioning, you know, I'm energetic. And there are times when, you know, I say it with a group of people, and the energy is quite, you know, down. And I'm all the way up there with my energy, and I just want to flow with my energy, but I have to come down. You know, to be able to match that, to be able to manage that, to be able to live in that, you can obviously tell that I'm different in that regard. However, being told that, you know, the fact that you're different doesn't mean that you have to conform, so keep being you, that alone is good enough for me. And I know that in everything that I'm doing, I'm different, and it's okay to be different. Okay. Is Dr. Kwame Ayi your dad? Oh, yes, yes, yes. Dr. Kwame Ayi is my father. Yes, a gynecologist. Yes. I wanted to be a gynecologist, you know, but time changed things. And as you grow, your dreams change as well. So, yes, Dr. Kwame Ayi is my father. I love you, daddy. Please, what is your biggest fear in life? Hallelujah. Amen. It's like I'm about to start a sermon right now. Ha ha. What is your biggest fear in life? In life, my biggest fear, I have two that I think are at par. Not fulfilling my purpose, my God-given purpose, is a big fear, you know, not fulfilling my God-given purpose before I leave. I want to leave empty, you know, knowing that I've done everything. God sends me to the world to do A, B, C, D, E, F, G, touch this number of people, change these people's lives. And I did all of that and more. Then there's the other one. Now I think I'll leave it here. Yeah. That's one of my biggest fears. The other one, I mean, I want to get to heaven, so I don't want to miss heaven. I don't want to miss it at all. Next question. Who's your favorite colleague at TV3? See, this question there, I cannot answer. Who is your favorite colleague at TV3? At TV3? I don't have a favorite colleague. I have favorites. So many of them. I have so many of them. And one beautiful thing with me is I connect easily with people. Very, very easily. And all the better if they are my kind, you know. All the better if they are my clan. And by my clan, I think you understand that, you know, there are people that, you know, just connect with easily. And then there are people that it takes time, even for them to get close to you. I will name some people, and I know that I would leave some people out, not because they are not my favorites, but perhaps because there isn't that much time to name all of them. Or I won't do that. But yeah, I have a lot of favorite colleagues, and I can't mention all of their names, but they know I love them so much. I love y'all. Y'all know yourselves. Yeah, y'all know yourself. Oh, and a happy birthday to one of them. Hi, Kawawa. Happy birthday to you. So the one who wanted to hear me sing, let me sing a happy birthday song to Kawawa. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Kawawa. Happy birthday. How are you there? To you. Remix! Happy birthday to you. Hey, happy birthday to you. Hey, happy birthday, Kawawa. Hey, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Woo, that was crazy. Next question. How was your experience the first time you went on air with Bella and Johnny? How was it like working with them? Good question. That's actually my first day on set. On New Day, my first day on New Day. My first day on New Day was nerve-wracking. I am not even going to lie. It was nerve-wracking. Aside the fact that we did it in a different setting altogether. And we started a bit later than we had planned to. So everything just hit me. It rained that day, you know, it rained that morning. And I was nervous. I was nervous that day. But as time went on, I was able to pick myself up. I had great colleagues to, you know, just help me through that period. It was a crazy day. It was a weird experience. I won't lie, it was a weird experience going through that day. I just remembered it like it was yesterday. But I thank God for growth and for all the things that I've learned along the way. Working with them was certainly a learning experience. I mean, it was quite a new, working with new people comes with learning and learning new things as well. Learning how to interact with different people, because you may have interacted with some personalities, but then again, if you've not worked with others, you'd have to learn to work with them as well. So it was a great experience. I enjoyed working with them every single day. It was fun. We had a great friendship as well. So everything was good, and I miss them actually. I do miss them, but I get to see them when I come to work. Yeah. All right. Great. Who's your favorite colleague at work? I think that one I said already. This is Brack. Hey, Brackofi, you've left Instagram. You've come here. Thank you so much for coming through. This is Brackofi. Please answer me, okay? I will not answer you, okay? This question now, you want to take me back to 20 BC. I will not do it. Oh, gosh. You want to embarrass me on the internet? It will not work, please. Please, have you ever contested on GMB before? No. I haven't contested on GMB before. And I don't know if perhaps you saw someone who looked like me, but no, it's just amazing that I got to, you know, host it. It's just a blessing. My cousin actually did contest. That was when, I think, in 2015 or 2014. And I found myself in the studios some Sunday nights just cheering her on. But I never was a contestant on the show. Oh, I miss you on TV3 New Day. Come back. I'll come back soon, okay? Very soon. But I'm on Lady Circle, which shows on Saturday at 6 p.m. from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. That's Lady Circle. And even before that, starting this Saturday from 5:30 to 6 p.m. is Battle of the Sexes. Don't you want to miss to not miss that one? Battle of the Sexes starts this Saturday, and you wouldn't want to miss that. So please tune in. You also have a chance to join in. So when you do tune in, you see how to be a part of the show as well. You can begin. Hey. I will do exactly that. I will do exactly that. Oh my goodness me. But I think I've had a good time on here. Tomorrow is a holiday. Tomorrow is the 1st of May, 2020. 2020 has been, should I start, a crazy year. It's not what we expected, but I believe that in every cloud there's a silver lining. I believe that in every situation there's something that you can take out of it. There's something amazing that can impact your life positively through the experience. And so my advice to anybody and everybody, including myself, is to just find those gems in whatever situation. Find those gems and roll with them. Build that solid connection with your God. And as we always say, pick up new skills. Even if it's just skills with people, interacting with people, whatever it is, the things that you've been meaning to do that you know will change your life for the better, you can start. And you don't have to do everything in one day. No, it's just a step at a time, a little at a time. So this has been my session on the Facebook Live, getting to know me. I hope, I think I've answered most of your questions. And if you have any further questions as well, you can ask me. I'm at Crystal, KIECHRYSTALKARYEE on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, on TikTok as well, and on YouTube. Don't ask me about my YouTube. You can follow me there, wait for me. It's fine. All right. A special thanks to Media General for this opportunity to interact with you. Special shout out to Media General. Thank you for, you know, taking a chance on me as well. Thank you for giving me this opportunity for my show as well. For my show as well on 3FM 92.7. That is tomorrow on Friday from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. It's the block party on 3FM 92.7. Join me there. Don't miss out on that one as well. And a special thanks to Media General Digital, the Media General Digital team. I need to drink water. The Media General Digital team for also, you know, putting all of this together. Really, if it wasn't for the digital team, we wouldn't have been, you know, having this interaction. So thank you, MG Digital, as well, to the whole of MG for this opportunity. Special shout outs to Lord Doku. I see you. Yeah. Special shout outs to Madam Beatrice. Hey, how are you doing? Shout outs to who again? Yay, Augustine Home. I see you. Augustine Home has been dancing back here all through. Oh, and Thierry Nyon. I think Thierry Nyon was here last week. Thierry Nyon. And if you don't know who Thierry Nyon is, that's Thierry Nyon. Special shout outs to you as well. To Bella, to Johnny, everybody. Nancy. Afefa. Oh, hi, what's good? I'm not mentioning any more names anyway, yes. Thierry Nyon.
Why are you using a camera and I didn't use a camera?
Leave there.
Ah, if you didn't use that camera, what did you use? Okay, we'll talk about that. Alright, thank you so much. And you can follow me on other social media platforms so that we can continue with this interaction. I hope you had a good time and goodbye.